Sarili bilang kandidato sa pagkapangulo sa halalan ng 2022.
So now Lenny has made it official. She's finally running as president for the 2022 national elections. Pero we need to talk about this. It took some time for her to decide on that, no? Pero dapat maintindihan natin kung bakit ganun katagal, on why she hesitated. She was trying to unite the opposition and help determine a viable candidate against a Marcos, against a Duterte. Kasi nire-recognize siya na malaki ang political capital ng kalaban. Imagine, she's entertaining the idea that a different candidate could be the one, not her? Well, because her numbers don't support it. She lacks campaign resources. Sa recent survey ratings, hindi pa nga siya part ng top 3. Nakapagtaka, no? Bakit ganun? She's very visible online. Clean track record and excellent performance. She has always been there. But maybe we need to acknowledge that we are in a progressive bubble. Tayo-tayo lang nakakita kung ano yung totoo. Unfortunately, she's the favorite target ng fake news. And for all we know, a big number of Filipinos believe these lies. The 2022 election is a crucial event. Ang laki ng pwedeng masayang if maging kampante tayo. We need to step up our game. Now, I'm not going to dictate on what exactly you need to do. I think you have an idea already. But let this be a guide. If you've been with Lenny since her VP run in 2016, we can't just settle for the same level of passion and commitment na ipinakita natin last time. She was able to win back then because other candidates underestimated her. This time, in the same way we are prepared to support her, other candidates and their troll armies are gearing for an attack. Kita nyo naman kung gaano sila kadumi maglaro since 2016 pa lang. Ginawa na nila yung unang hakbang. Sana wag naman natin siya iwan sa laban. Kailangan na kailangan ni Lenny ang bawat isa sa atin sa darating na halalan. It's selfish for us to push her to run as president, but we're not willing to share the burden. Mahirap ang mga susunod na buwan. Malakas ang makinarya ng kalaban. Pero kung ano man ang kaya nilang bayaran, kung ano man ang kaya nilang ibentang kasinungalingan, walang makakatalo sa liga ng mga supporters at volunteers na magtutulungan. Maging tayo yung tugon sa kung ano man ang kakulangan sa budget ni Lenny. Tayo na mismo ang sumagot at bumara sa bawat fake news tungkol sa kanya. Hindi lang ito laban ni Lenny. Laban nating lahat ito. Because if we want Lenny to lead the Philippines, we should let her feel we got her back. Sabay-sabay nating bigkasin. Maria Leonor Gerona Rebredo, Lenny, 17th President of the Philippines.
I had no money, I had nothing. I was the only, Jesse was the only one in the family who was a politician. And I was running against someone who was coming from the most powerful political dynasty in our province. Parang hirap na hirap. Hirap na hirap, I remember my first, after I filed my certificate of candidacy, my first concern was I needed a sound system so that when I go around I can hold meetings, I can hold rallies. So I was looking for a sound system. They were telling me I can rent one, but when I asked, it was 7,000 a day. I didn't have money. Sabi ko, hindi na lang ako magre-rent. Tatsagaan ko na lang nalakad. Total local naman yon. So, tsinagaan kong maglakad. Ang wala akong dala. Talagang ano lang. Hanggang may friend kami na naawa sa akin, niregaluhan ako ng portable. I don't know if you have seen one of those. It's a portable sound system. Wala siyang mic. Meron lang siya yung kiniklip na lapel. May kiniklip na lapel. Nakakarinig yata mga 10 hanggang 20 tao. Ang nakakatawa pa doon kasi you have to recharge it every 2 hours. So, parati ako naghahanap. May dala ako ng extension wire na sobrang haba kasi I have to recharge. And then when my opponent would know where I was, sasabayan niya yung meetings ko. Siyempre yung meeting ko sa mga 10 tao, sa mga bahay-bahay lang. Pag sinabayan niya yung meetings ko, he would be bringing with him a napakalakas na sound system. Tapos, he had entertainers. May singers, may dancers, and he would be giving away food packs. Meron pa siyang raffle ng appliances. So, if 10 to 20 people were attending my meetings, thousands would attend his. Of the 8 mayors in my district, only one was for me. Of 186 barangays, only 25 barangay captains were supporting me. They wouldn't allow me to use their barangay halls. They wouldn't allow me to use their covered courts. They wouldn't allow me to use their plazas kasi natatakot sila dun sa kalaban ko. Day of the elections, ang watchers ko naman, volunteers, bring your own baon. They brought their baons inside the precinct. Katabi nila yung watchers ng kalaban ko. Yung watchers ng kalaban ko, merong morning snacks, merong afternoon snacks, tapos yung lunch nila, Jollibee, McDonald's. No one thought that I would win. Pero nung nagbilangan, I won by almost 80% of the votes.